Speaking on the sidelines of the launch, the minister noted that government was taking agriculture seriously since it's the fastest way to create a green environment and provide adequate food to the citizens. He said the irrigation equipment will be distributed countrywide under the parish development model.
What the Standard Chartered Bank is talking about is saying use clean technologies. So they are going to be funding clean technologies. That's what the bank is saying. And that's what everybody who is involved in manufacturing should be looking at. And we are very lucky that the funding institutions are now saying, led by Standard Chartered Bank, is that let us adopt technologies that are green, that will save our environment. And these technologies are available, as the MD of Standard Chartered Bank said, they are available in the world. But people want to avoid them because they are not cautious about the damage they are causing.
Bahati reiterated President Museveni's call to all who have encroached on the wetlands to vacate, adding that in some special cases, government will compensate the occupants of some wetlands who are in possession of land titles.
We need to protect our climate. We owe it to humanity. We owe it to our children. It's important to save humanity about this looming disaster, looming crisis. Let us not have anything to explain to our children or grandchildren that we didn't know that there was this looming crisis. It is here with us and we must work on it. And that's why you've heard President Museveni talk about issues of the wetlands. There are two types of wetlands in Uganda. There are those that were handed over to the citizens of the country by the colonial governments, especially in the area where I come from. But there are others who just invaded the wetland.
Meanwhile, StanChart's CEO said the bank has set up a $300 billion fund to mitigate against climate change. He said of the 66,000 clients they have in Uganda, 90% have embraced paperless digital transactions, one of the ways to save trees.
I've also seen what's happening in Uganda is happening in Tanzania. You know, climate is, the weather patterns are changing, there are floods, there's disruption, water shortage, and all these things become very critical for us because we have a huge future. And most of us here are decision makers, that we as leaders need to make sure that our future generation, you know, it has a better state. So for Standard Chartered Bank, our commitment is we are the world's most sustainable and responsible bank. Worldwide, we have also put up a big transition finance, you know, capital. We've actually put together $300 billion across the world that are going to go for climate imperatives or initiatives.
Story by Rix Kaizi for the news.